When people say they're nostalgic for classic television, they usually mean the shows. But for Rick Klein, it's the total viewing experience that gets him excited, and that means the commercials, the promotional announcements, the station IDs, you know, all the stuff that often gets forgotten. That's where Klein comes in. He scours flea markets, garage sales, estate sales, people's basements, and the internet in search of old home videotapes. He then edits out all those between show parts and posts them on his fuzzymemories.tv, also known by its full name, the Museum of Classic Chicago Television. Klein first caught the bug when he discovered a dusty videotape of his childhood experience on Bozo Circus.
I was 9 years old. It was 1983, and it was a Christmas show. And we actually didn't have a VCR at the time, so we had to have a family friend record it for us. And that was pretty much the first tape that I discovered years later, looking in an old cabinet of ours, and where I really started to say, wow, this stuff is neat to see again, and it should be preserved, because I realized that WGN doesn't have a lot of these episodes, so really the only existing copies may be ones that people recorded at home.
And your content, the content that that's on your website, includes all that kind of stuff?
I don't leave anything no stone left unturned. I pretty much put everything, even if it's extremely obscure, just because usually a clip that I think wouldn't be interesting to anyone else, someone finds it interesting and says, wow, I remember that. That really brought home a memory to me. So I just put everything I can find. Yeah, commercials. One example I have that was pretty neat is Harry Carey doing a commercial for La Preferida Mexican Foods, which was kind of a strange endorsement, I think. You know, you'd think he'd be doing hot dogs or something like that, but there's a commercial with him being Harry, and that was an interesting one from 1980 that I found.
Hello again, everybody. This is Harry Carey. You know, working a ball game really makes me hungry, and when I'm hungry, I can't help but think of the great Mexican foods made with La Preferida products. Just as a home run adds excitement to a baseball game.
There's the commercials, the things that are called bumpers, which are the little things that go in and out of the commercial breaks. And
yeah, coming up is so-and-so and so.
Yeah,
stuff like
or
that, yeah.
We'll be right back, you know, those type of things.
Game show excitement when contestants challenge the one-armed bandit on The Joker's Wild. Tonight at 7 on Channel 32.
And, you know, it's amazing that this material would again be lost if it wasn't for the home video recordings, because the TV stations, they just didn't have the facilities to save very much of this material. Videotape was very expensive back then. They had to reuse it several times, or they just didn't think it was going to be of any value.
I want to talk about how you access that stuff that people have at home, but first, how did the advent of YouTube influence what you do?
When YouTube came about and I realized how easy it was to put video online and how good it looked, frankly, I started to realize that anybody can sort of have their own little shop of memories. But I wanted to take it one step further, perhaps, and just focus exclusively on Chicago and local recordings and try to do some research and find out when each of these recordings were actually recorded. You know, I use different clues in the program. Maybe if there's a movie trailer or something that says the movie is coming out on Friday, you know, and then I can look it up on another source and find out when this particular program aired. And when I find the exact date, it really kind of brings it to a specific, very specific place. So it's like time traveling almost.
But you got to do this, you have to do this randomly though, because when you get this stuff that people have that they've recorded on their VCRs, you sort of just cast a wide net. I mean, it's not like you sit down one day and say, well, let me see what happened, who's got 1986,
right? It is pretty random. From doing this for a while, I can tell by the video cassette covers, usually like how old the tapes might be, so I can have a look out and say, those look like they might be more of a 70s vintage, and so there'd be earlier material from there. And to tell you the truth, I mean, material recorded in the 70s, anything is worthwhile, because it's pretty rare. You know, as you probably know, not a lot of people had VCRs back then. They were pretty expensive. So anything you can find is just a kind of a little jewel. You know.
So how far back do you go?
The earliest recording I found personally is from 1976, actually December recorded in Rockford, Illinois. And this gentleman got in touch with me, and his father, from what he claims, had one of the first Betamax recording machines in Rockford. And
the Betamax, that was the one that got beat out.
That's right. And, you know, actually,
the system got beat out, yeah.
Yeah, and you know, maybe it's too bad because the Beta tapes actually look better than VHS.
Well, the quality was better, just, you know, they lost the battle in terms of marketing.
They did. It's too bad they did. But it's amazing that these tapes survive so many years, 30-some-odd years, and, you know, and that's why I kind of feel like I owe it to the person that recorded it into the material to preserve it, because it's this little slice of history, and it's survived for all these years, and so, you know, people should see it.
The best in sports, the most in sports, WSNS TV 44 Chicago.
This is 848 on Chicago Public Radio, WBEZ. We're talking to Rick Klein, founder of Fuzzy Memories TV, a website designed to be an online museum using off-air recordings of local television content that includes not only shows, but promos, commercials, PSAs, bumpers, and everything else going back at least 25, maybe 30 years. Is this stuff mostly from the independent stations, say a Channel 26 before it was the U,
right?
Channel 66 back in the days before it was Spanish language programming. What others? Channel 60?
32. Before, there was, back when it was Field
WFLD, right.
Yeah, probably the majority of it is, you know, but there's some network promos and things.
Your summer favorites are back to strut their stuff. It's Roger, Dwayne, and Rerun. There's Roger's mama and his lovable sister, Dee. It's the premiere of the show that answers the hilarious question, what's happening?
Next Saturday night on ABC.
And again, it's like there's not too many places where you can see this material other than YouTube or sites that have been purposely set up like mine.
You have Sven Gulli?
Oh, yeah. We got the son of Sven Gulli. That was his original show. And, yeah, he's a big favorite of mine when I was growing up. And he's a jewel for Chicago. And he's still doing it, still going strong.
Hello again, you geologists of ghoulish gossip. We've got one right up your alley today. It's Joan Crawford, whose nasty nature was revealed in the book Mommy Dearest, starring in Throg. Yes, Throg, the story of a half-man, half-ape, missing link discovered in the modern world. And wait till you see this crazed, rampaging, inhuman beast who, as I've already mentioned, is called
Joan Crawford!
Not quite that. And no wire hangers.
Now, is there any financial incentive for you to do this? And, you know, what fuels this thing?
Well, it's really just, I guess, a personal passion of mine to collect this material and to preserve it. Because, you know, when I find an old dusty tape at a flea market and it has, say, a Bozo episode on there from 1978, I realize that it's not available anywhere else, that WGN most likely doesn't even have it in their archives, which I'm pretty sure of, because the NBC has what WGN has and vice versa pretty much, you know. But when I find this, I want to preserve it because this is somebody that was on the show and, you know, it was a big moment for them. I mean, I remember how big of a deal it was for me to be on the show, and I was glad that I had that videotape. And, you know, so this really needs to be preserved, and it's like the off-air recordings just aren't getting enough respect, and they deserve to be thought of as historical documents just as much as something that might have been donated directly from a studio, you know. So maybe my museum is sort of a people's museum, you know, but it's still worthy. It still has a place, I think.
As we wind down, what's your favorite stuff?
Well, you know, I have so many. I think the most recent clips that I find are sometimes my favorite just because I'm excited about them that I found them. But things like the old Channel 32 used to have commercial bumpers for cartoons, and, you know, they'd sing a little song.
In Chicago, the kids' choices, Channel 32.
And, you know, even things like the old emergency broadcast system test, you know, where they'd have that tone that would just scare the bejeebus out of you.
This is a test. For the next 60 seconds, this station will conduct a test of the emergency broadcast system. This is only a test.
There's so many little things, and that's an example of some little thing that might be thought of as just not very interesting, but people still enjoy seeing it, and it evokes a lot of memories that people enjoy.
Rick Klein, founder of Fuzzy Memories TV, a website designed to be an online museum using off-air recordings of local television content that includes promos and commercials and PSAs and bumpers going back at least 25 years, but sometimes further than that. Rick, thanks a lot for being with us today.
Thanks a lot. I enjoyed it.
Well, do you have any fuzzy memories lying around your house? Donate them to the Museum of Classic Chicago Television. Rick will burn them onto a DVD for you and post them on the site. For more information, go to our website, chicagopublicradio.org/848.